Today's choral evensong was recorded in Rochester Cathedral. The canticles are sung to the second service by William Byrd, and the anthem, with music by Sir Edward Elgar, is the prologue to his oratorio, The Apostles, The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The service opens with the introit, There is a stream which issues forth from God's eternal throne, the words by a 17th century poet, John Mason, and set to music by a former cathedral organist at Rochester, Dr. Robert Ashfield.
Psalms 82, 83, 84, and 85.
Thank you. first lesson is taken from the book Ecclesiasticus, chapter 39. He that hath applied his soul meditateth in the law of the Most High. He will seek out the wisdom of all the ancients and will be occupied in prophecies. He will keep the discourse of the men of renown and will enter in amidst the subtleties of parables. He will seek out the hidden meaning of proverbs and be conversant in the dark sayings of parables. He will serve among great men and appear before him that ruleth. He will travel through the land of strange nations, for he hath tried good things and evil among men. He will apply his heart to resort early to the Lord that made him, and will make supplication before the Most High. He will open his mouth in prayer, and will make supplication for his sins. If the great Lord will, he shall be filled with the spirit of understanding. He shall pour forth the words of his wisdom, and in prayer give thanks unto the Lord. He shall direct his counsel and knowledge, and in his secrets shall he meditate. He shall show forth the instruction which he has been taught, and shall glory in the law of the covenant of the Lord. Many shall commend his understanding, and so long as the world endureth, it shall not be blotted out. His memorial shall not depart, and his name shall live from generation to generation. Nations shall declare his wisdom, and the congregation shall tell out his praise. If he continue, he shall leave a greater name than 1,000, and if he die, he addeth thereto. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
Here begins the 13th chapter of the Revelation to John. And I saw a beast rising out of the sea with 10 horns and 7 heads, with 10 diadems upon its horns and a blasphemous name upon its heads. And the beast that I saw was like a leopard. Its feet were like a bear's, and its mouth was like a lion's mouth. And to it the dragon gave his power and his throne and great authority. One of its heads seemed to have a mortal wound, but its mortal wound was healed, and the whole earth followed the beast with wonder. Men worshipped the dragon, for he had given his authority to the beast, and they worshipped the beast, saying, "Who is like the beast, and who can fight against it?" And the beast was given a mouth uttering haughty and blasphemous words, and it was allowed to exercise authority for 42 months. It opened its mouth to utter blasphemies against God, blaspheming his name and his dwelling, that is, those who dwell in heaven. Also, it was allowed to make war on the saints and to conquer them. And authority was given it over every tribe and people and tongue and nation. And all who dwell on earth will worship it, everyone whose name has not been written before the foundation of the world in the book of life of the Lamb that was slain. If anyone has an ear, let him hear. If anyone is to be taken captive, to captivity he goes. If anyone slays with the sword must he be slain. Here is a call for the endurance and faith of the saints. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you. Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Thank you. and charity towards your people. Grant that we, who commemorate her life of holiness, may be constant in prayer and fruitful in good works, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commands, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Light in our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ.
Anthem, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. Music by Edward Elgar.
Let us pray. Let us pray for the church throughout the world, especially remembering today the Episcopal Church of the United States of America, particularly the Bishop of Vermont, Bishop Robert Kerr, and the clergy and people of his diocese. In our own diocese of Rochester, we pray for David, our bishop, and the representatives of the House of Leighton, Brian Vaughan, Robert Berry, James Cheeseman, William Price, David Webster, and Colin Williamson. Almighty God, you have called your church to share in your mission to the whole world. Give to us and to all your people such belief in the gospel and such faithfulness in service, that the life of mankind may be renewed in the knowledge and love of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
God our Father, whose Son Jesus Christ looked with compassion on the hungry people of his day and fed them, hear us as we pray in his name for the starving and undernourished peoples of our world. Show us who have so much, what we can do to help those who have so little, and guide and prosper the efforts of those who plan relief and are giving aid, that out of your bounty to mankind, the needs of all may be supplied.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen.
Hymn number 196 in the English hymnal.
Oh,
Flourish for an Occasion by Sir William Harris brings to a close today's choral evensong, which was recorded in Rochester Cathedral.